a teenager, I was interested in drama and photography, but didn't know that there was even such a thing as directing. And I think that, you know, now I think that was because there were no female role models, so, you know, I wasn't aware of it. And I then began to think, oh, maybe I wanted to make documentaries. And that was fascinating, and really I learned about the world. I saw some films by female directors that helped. I saw Mira Nair and Agnes Varda. And then I applied for the National Film and Television School. And, you know, the combination of a peer group and tutors and facilities and deadlines and all that made it possible to make some short films. And that was really such an important learning curve. On the back of that, I was able to go on to make longer films. I feel when I make a film, I always have to have a personal connection to it. I don't think I can be a director for hire, although maybe that would be a relief, but anyway. But I've always had to evolve, you know, work with the subject matter and really get under the skin of it. And the themes that I've inevitably ended up doing are very female-centric. It's partly that there aren't many of those stories out there, and they're the stories I want to see, and partly just that's in my DNA, that's what I'm interested in. It's really on the set, trial and error. You just sort of intuit, and or they ask you, or they require, or they're looking. But I think the most important thing as a director is to give instant feedback. You know, so you do a take, you have to go straight up to the actors and give them some feedback. And always sort of, and give them the good feedback first, and not too many notes. And, you know, you have 25 notes, you give them one. And often the one deals with the 25, you know, so it's a lot about kind of finding your way, but I think you've just got to remember that they are so exposed and they've done something and they need to, you're the reflection of them.
Thank you.